My parents brought me here when I was around 15 years old on a tour. I studied Indonesian in high school and then went on a quick trip to Jogja and Bali, and then I did some of my degree at the University of Gajah Mada and the Institute of Arts when I was studying at UTS.
Rebecca's first real involvement in the Indonesian culture was centered around the Indonesian arts community, where she was able to put her skill set and knowledge to good use by giving back to the community through mediums such as radio to teach and educate the less advantaged and homeless. She has since spent the last decade firmly cemented in the Indonesian and Asian media scene, where she has worked in many different capacities for companies such as ABC, SBS and Tempo TV.
There's been an explosion in artistic expression in the country. Before, there were strict controls on what you could do on stage, but now artists are seeing a relaxation of the rules.
Since relocating to Indonesia, Rebecca has covered three of the most controversial and expensive national elections, has been exposed to many human rights and environmental issues, and all the while making it her mission to train and mentor local journalists. Rebecca is regarded for presenting Indonesian issues free of bias, and helps to shift much of the sensationalist reporting in Australia on Indonesia. Additionally, she has worked as the Journalism Program Officer for ACSIX since 2013, mentoring many young Australian journalists in how to successfully report in Indonesia and capture unique, game-changing stories.
I love the dynamic nature of being a journalist in Indonesia. I love the fact that people are not cynical about the media as they might be in the West, that people want to tell you their stories and they're excited to be interviewed.
Rebecca is the executive producer and presenter of the cutting-edge television show Asia Calling.
Asia Calling is a regional current affairs program. We go behind the news to investigate how the events of the day are really affecting people's lives. We don't just talk to politicians or human rights activists, but we really go on the ground to meet the people who are affected by events, but also people who are changing our region for the better.
Well, I think it's often said, but it's really about the people-to-people links, and it's about people like myself or others who end up living here for a long period of time, learning the language, and then Indonesians start to see Australia as a face, as a person that they know, rather than perhaps what many people see as an arrogant neighbour that tells them what to do. So you get a more relationship that builds over time.